Hey everybody, Master of Scene 93. Yeah. We're back with I Want to Die in what's going to be week 2, but first we're going to do some recruiting. And by that I mean we're going to beg and plead to these recruits to sign with our team because we're pretty bad. We're a one-star program. Very few of these people are going to say, hey, yeah, Washington State, let's go ahead, sign me up for that bitch. Let's see here.
Pretty much,
I want to look for anybody with at least a high 60 or low 70 overall rating.
The only kind of people you're going to get are the nerds that actually go to school to learn.
Unfortunately, that might be it. That might actually be the case. People who are there for the education.
Who goes to college for education?
Smart people. We're not one of those people. Okay, so that's a 68 overall linebacker.
Speak for yourself. I'm in college.
Well, I'm not in college, so I can't speak for myself.
I'm not smart, though. I'm definitely not smart. But anyway,
I'm just basically going after anybody with at least like a 65 or a 66 overall rating. Anything better than that, obviously, but a lot of these players are probably going to end up signing with Washington State for no other reason than other schools are straight up rejecting them because they're so bad and they have to go with Washington State because no other team will want them. You know, those kinds of players.
Those people.
So what are you doing in Madden?
What am I doing in Madden? I'm trying to become the only white running back to be successful.
Oh, that's right. Good luck with that. Alright, so we have a 67 overall tackle. That's not bad. Go after him. Roderick Chambers, an 80 overall corner. I'm going full speed ahead on that guy. He's a 4-star corner, number 2 overall rated corner. Not bad. A 69 overall wide receiver. We don't have a needed wide receiver, but I'm just going after anybody. Ha ha, so mature.
Yes.
A 79 overall corner. So we got some nice corners on this recruiting board here. I'm just going maximum point spread on these guys, giving them all the points into these players. Hopefully I can sign at least one of them. Even if I don't get all of these players, if I could just get one of them to sign with Washington State, that would be cool. And a 80 overall defensive end, Justin Nicholson. I guess I'll go after him. Alright, but enough of that. You're not here just to watch recruiting, you're here to watch me lose against the Trojans of USC.
I mean, we beat Auburn, so...
Yeah, the USC is considerably harder. I'm talking like almost equivalent to all Madden mode kind of difficulty just because players. Just because of the talent on this team, on this roster.
Well, fam, maybe if you don't have a safety this time, maybe we might.
Maybe. Maybe if I don't throw 4 interceptions.
What the hell is this depth chart? There's it goes me at 79, 83, 87, 85.
Huh? What?
Like the halfback depth chart for the team I'm on, the Falcons. It's me at 79.
It's reversed. It's reversed.
It's not reversed, though.
Oh.
It's 79, 83, 87, 85.
Because the original recording of episode 1 got basically cut in half. Yes, it was a 50-minute video, but it was cut in half. That's how long episode 1 was originally. You guys did not even get to see like my roster in its entirety because like for the first 50 minutes of episode 1, I was just talking about my roster and stuff like that.
We had to go over the little Steve Smith.
Yes. Steve Smith. We're going over the roster again because you guys haven't seen this in full yet. We have a 60, not 60, but an 86 overall quarterback, Corey Green, redshirt junior. 82 overall, James Coe, who's a sophomore. I stated in the previous video I thought he was a junior or a senior, but that's incorrect. He is a sophomore, and he played good, so I'm going to feed him the ball a lot more in the next game. Wade Roberts, 85 overall, redshirt sophomore. Pretty good. He actually could be a draft pick by the time he gets into his redshirt senior year. Another sophomore, a true sophomore, Anthony Hampton, my slot guy, 82 overall. Quinton Williams, a junior, 82. Rounding out the starting 4-5 wide receiver sets, we have Jason Washington, a true freshman, and Nelson Vincent, the player of the game in game one, is actually a 73 overall, but he has 90 speed, so he does have the ability to stretch the field.
He got them legs.
He's got those John Ross legs. Did you see what John Ross did?
Was it 4.22?
It was 4.22. It was faster than Chris Johnson. We have Will Glover, our receiving tight end, 67 overall. 80 overall left tackle, Brandon Moses. Doug Whaley, 80 overall left tackle. 79 overall, Adam Grimes, senior center. Zach Love, senior right guard, 81 overall. 82 overall, right tackle, Trey Glover. Then on the defensive line, we have 80 overall, Brad Whitaker, senior. 80 overall, sophomore, Zach Woods. A pair of 81 overall defensive tackles, Anthony Scott and Shannon Phillips. Anthony Scott being a junior, Phillips is a senior. We have Cole Rice, true junior, left outside linebacker. The captain of this defense is Desmond Hollis, the most middle inside linebacker name to ever exist.
Desmond Hollis.
Rounding out the linebacking corps, our starting on the right outside is James Thompson, a junior. And then at corner, we have Steve Smith, 82 overall. But that's not all, because we have Steve Smith, junior.
Now, we should point out, they were both originally Steve Smith.
Like, yes, I changed it to junior because I just couldn't deal with both of those names being Steve Smith. So let me change this now. I was going to change it. I'm going to change it to where the second Steve Smith is just Steve Smith, and the first one is going to be Steve Smith Sr.
This is why you use accurate rosters.
Yes. I'm going to change it for the better. It's not Steve Smith Jr., it's Steve Smith Sr. Wrong one. There we go. Steve Smith Sr.
Yay. By the way, how many views did our first video get?
I haven't uploaded it yet. Remember, I'm recording some of these in advance before I start uploading. We have Bill McNair. 74 overall senior free safety, and then senior strong safety. 84 overall, Michael Moyer, the other main face of the defense. And then we got a couple of senior punters and kickers, a 92 overall kicker, a 80 overall punter. Speaking of which, reason why I'm kind of bulk recording, because I want you to go ahead and get started on making a thumbnail for me, something that I can use when I do upload. Yeah, get started on that, fam. Soon.
You don't boss me, fam.
Get started on it soon. I'm going to take away your Madden 08 rights.
You don't control me. I am a strong, independent white running back.
You are. You are a strong, independent white running back. You know what you are? You are that running back that the Vikings drafted for some reason when they had Adrian Peterson.
Toby Gerhardt.
You're Toby Gerhardt. That's basically who you are.
Except hopefully not as bad.
So in USC's first game, they scored 29 points on offense and they gave up only 10 points on defense. Wow. So if we score more than 10 points, I'm considering that a good game, because that's who they kept their first opponent to. Only 10 points. Blah, blah, blah. Nobody cares about the intros. It's all cinematic and stuff, but I just wanted to get to the game, because if I'm going to lose, let's get it over with.
You gotta believe.
Hey, we won the coin toss, though. So I will kick that. I won the ball first in the start of the second half. And game two of our Washington State dynasty is underway. It's the first Pac-12 game of the year. Our first game against Auburn was a non-conference game, obviously. So winning these Pac-12 games are more important in just the terms of getting positioning in conference. You want to have as many conference wins as possible. Too many conference losses, and sometimes even just one conference loss can rule out any chance of going to a BCS game, because in order to go to the Rose Bowl, you have to win the Pac. Oh my gosh, that's a bad first play. I was going to say, the only way to get to the Rose Bowl most of the time is just to outright win the Pac-12, unless you're an at-large bid. Well, the first play on offense was a 29-yard reception, so that's not a good way to start the game. Damn. They have a lot of talented players on this team, as you're about to find out. Another completion, 19 yards down the left sideline off of play action to Mark White. This is getting ugly, and it's only the third play of the game now.
Bam.
Our pass defense did a really good job in the last game against Auburn, but it's not off to a good start here. And it's another completion, this time to Elton Greer, and it's our... It's by far our worst defensive series so far this season. Anthony Sims, the starting quarterback, is 3-for-3 for 66 yards in the first drive. They're at their own, no, not their own, but my own 10-yard line. The first really good play on defense, they hand off the ball to Marcus Fenner for a loss of 1 yard. Fenner. So our run defense continues to be impressive. I don't care if we give up 400 yards passing. If we can just hold his running back to a very short day offensively, at least that means we know we can key in and focus on just one aspect of the offense. So they hand it back to Fenner, only gains 1 yard. So it's third and goal at the 9-yard line. If we can hold him to a field goal here, I will be very impressed, because it looked like for a while there we were going to just be a runaway train on offense and not be able to stop anything they did.
Pretty much.
And we do stop them. They throw it to the running back, but it's incomplete. So they actually get down to the 9-yard line, but they have to settle for a field goal.
I mean, it's better than starting out 0-7.
Absolutely. It's not even an easy field goal. It's off the right hash mark, so he has to... Well, he does get it in there. He had to kick it on an angle into the goalpost, but he does get it, so it's 3-0. Kind of a crazy kick, because if you overshot it or undershot it, I guess you could say, it could have been a really... ugly miss, but he got it in there. So now we get the ball back to Bishop on the kick return. He gets out to about, it looks like, the 25-yard line. So our quarterback, Corey Green, comes back in. No, it was actually the 20-yard line. He had 4 interceptions, as we know of, in the last game. We want to minimize that, and I plan on minimizing that by not throwing to start the game, because I'm going to try and feed the ball to Co and see if I can't get him rolling early on. So we hand off to Co off the counter, and he does get a couple of good yards on the first run, about 8 yards.
Does anybody remember Co Simpson, by the way?
I do remember Co Simpson.
It's just Co reminded me of Co Simpson, and apparently he's in jail, I guess, maybe.
So we go play action and get the ball off to Will Glover, and it's a 7-yard completion, first down. Move those chains. Going no huddle, just to see if we can't get a USC to maybe make a mistake here, going no huddle. We swing it out to Co off the swing pass. Gets about, well, only a yard, maybe 2 yards. Just trying to go tempo here just to see if we can't maybe get a huge play down the middle of the field. On now second down and 9. Oh, and that's an interception.
Bam. But here's a question. Will USC blow a 3-0 lead?
They can. See, I thought that was a good play because it looked like he wasn't going to be able to get to that ball. I threw it on a post to Wade Roberts on the right, and it wasn't even a corner who intercepted it. It was a linebacker playing zone coverage. And it didn't look like he was going to be in position. He just stretched out at the very last second and just robbed me there.
He OBJ'd it.
He didn't quite OBJ it, but he came close. He robbed me of what looked like a very easy completion. So they throw the ball to Justin Davis.
Hand grenades.
Yeah. I'm not proud to say that I've thrown 5 interceptions to start the year. I'm in game 2. So we actually blitz on that, and it's a loss of 2 yards. So Marcus Fenner has ran the ball 3 times, and he's got negative yardage to show for it. second and 12. If we can hold them to another field goal attempt here, at least it's still only a one possession game.
Yeah.
And then they throw it down the middle. It's wide open to Marcus Wheatley, 17 yards. I'm not even playing corner right now. I'm playing defensive line and linebacker, and my CPU defensive players in the secondary are not getting in good position to stop the passes. They're just letting players run right past them. Exactly. He almost got in there on a swing pass. He kind of stumbled at the very last second, gets stopped probably at the 1-inch line from the goal line. But it's likely going to be a touchdown unless we can get a miraculous stop here on the goal line. It's literally like right on the edge of the goal line here. They hand it off to Finner once again, and he gets in. Just couldn't get there fast enough. Touchdown, USC.
Bam.
This is not a good start to the game. We actually had a very good start to the game against Auburn in the sense that we kept it very close throughout, and only in the second half for a portion of the game did it look like we were maybe going to blow it. But now we're in the first quarter. The game just started and it's already 10-0. So this is not what I was looking forward to. But then again, it is USC. I mean, I knew this game was going to be hard.
And just remember, Atlanta blew a 28-3 lead, so you can come back.
True. Bishop does get a good return there. He gets about a 34, 35 yard return. Bishop has been very good returning the ball. So we go play action on first down. And we get the ball to Wade Roberts, a gain of 24 yards.
Nice.
Sometimes you have to just throw deep, because some of these passes that are getting interceptions are short to intermediate. I have to go deep to stretch this defense. We actually keep the ball on the quarterback option to Corey Green, and he gets 10 yards, first down.
Nice.
So we go no huddle.
You're getting some momentum now.
Absolutely. Another read option to the quarterback because we're going no huddle, and USC is not ready for it, and we get a huge run, 22 yards. USC was not ready for consecutive read options.
Got wheels.
He's not fast, but he's deceptively shifty when he's running the read option.
So he's Tony Romo.
Maybe not quite Tony Romo, but
well, has he broken his has he broken his collarbone yet? And his back?
He has not.
And everything else imaginable.
Every bone in his body, just like that fish from SpongeBob.
Does his back hurt?
His back hurts. His back always hurts. So we go in to pass the ball here on second down. Nobody's open. I'm scrambling around trying to find something. We throw the ball to Wade Roberts at the last second. He catches it. It gets down to the 1 yard line. So it looks like we can at least answer here and hopefully punch this in for a touchdown.
That'll get it back to a 3-point game.
We hand the ball off to James Coe up the middle, and it's a touchdown.
Now, if I may say, personally, I think the team that scores the most points is going to win the game.
Phil Sims with the great insight there. Great commentary.
To get the most points, you have to score the most times and get the most points. To score the most points.
10-7. USC still with the field goal lead as we kick the ball off. Davis on the return. He's running up the middle. He's got some open room. Finally get there to stop them, but they do get out to about the 32 or 33 yard line. Our special teams is not doing a good job of getting the blockers, or I guess you could say, what do they call them when they run down the field?
I honestly don't know.
There's a word for it. I forget what it's called. Desmond Hollis, great tackle behind the line, lost the 2 yards.
That's our linebacker.
Second and 12. I mean, I'm pretty sure they're going to throw the ball here, so let's just maybe... No, they're actually going with the redraw. Marcus Finner, 1 yard loss. They went with the draw for some reason. He's carried the ball 70 times for 1 yard, but he has a touchdown though.
I mean, those TDs.
That's some Jerome Bettis bullshit right there. They passed the ball wide open. Bullshit. Marcus Wheatley, 34 yards.
Bam.
It's not just bad enough that they're throwing to wide open receivers, but the receivers are getting yards after the catch because my defenders are just completely blown away by the breakaway speed. They're not even in position to try and contest these passes. They're five steps ahead of the corners. And that's pass interference on Washington State. No, it's not pass interference. It's roughing the passer, really? I thought that was pass interference because it looked like I interfered there, but they're just calling roughing the passer instead.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, they're both 15 yards, right?
Yeah, I'm not liking this officiating. I'm going to call biased referees. This is at USC, after all.
Fam, you nailed their quarterback like six steps after.
I did not. There's no video evidence of that. Another completion down to the 4 yard line. I chose to send the blitz there and it did not work out. I chose to send the blitz that time and it did work out.
Nice.
Michael Moyer, the safety, gets in the backfield for the blitz and for the sack. Second and goal at the 10 yard line. They run it with Marcus Finner. He gets maybe 2 yards, maybe a yard and a half, actually. So as the first quarter is winding down, 6 seconds, 5 seconds, they might get this playoff before the first quarter is officially over. And they do. And it's a sack. Washington State closes out the first quarter with back-to-back sacks. USC still does have the ball. Attempting a very easy field goal here, straight down the middle, to go up by 6.
Oh, so fam, you may be interested to hear, like, getting close to the end of the first half of this game, I have 38 yards, but I also have a passing touchdown.
Good shit. And they convert on the field goal to go up 13-7. But nice job by Washington State there. They got down to the 4-yard line, but we got back-to-back sacks to keep them out the end zone. Bishop, I mean, on the return.
He if gets you sack the quarterback yards. Every play, you're going to win.
I'm supposed to win if I sack the quarterback every play, supposedly.
Well, if you just sack the quarterback every play.
So we go back on offense. See if we can't get a touchdown here and go up by 1 point. That would be nice. We throw the ball off to James Coe off the play action to James Coe. 8 yards on the completion. I've only thrown one incompletion that ended up being an interception. I've completed all my passes besides that. Ooh, we hand off the ball to James Coe, and that's a loss of 4 yards.
Don't lose yards, fam.
Trying not to, fam. I don't say to myself, let's lose yards on this play.
You sure about that, fam?
I'm pretty sure. Third and 6. Go back to pass. That's wide open to Will Glover. We convert. Get to about the 40-yard line. See, the thing is, there are going to be receivers open on every play for the most part. I just have to throw to the right guy. And 5 times this year, I have not done that.
See, this time I can't see it. So I can't say, oh, that dude was open. What are you even doing?
Yeah, you can't criticize me. You're not going to be able to criticize me in real time.
I'm still going to criticize you.
No, I'm just saying, you're not going to be able to criticize me in real time until Discord makes it to where you can do video sharing on computer screens. That video to video, or whatever it's called. Screen share, yeah, that's what it's called. Until we can do that, you're not going to be able to see it.
That's what you think.
So we actually go read option to Corey Green, but he loses 2 yards there. The defensive lineman did bite on the running back, but they had somebody else blitzing off the edge, so we lost 2 yards there. We actually had a completion down the middle, but they made the hit and knocked it loose. So it's 3rd and 12. I hate those plays more than any other, because you know that it's, for the most part, the correct decision to throw the ball to that person. And there's nothing you can do about it if they end up dropping it from the hit, though. I mean, it's like, you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. 3rd and 12, we have to go for it. We throw it to Washington, and we convert. Gain of 20.
Nice.
Very nice.
Very,
so we keep the drive alive. Corey Green, 8 for 10. Other than the one interception, he's been pretty much on point, throwing most of these passes. Oh, and we get sacked there. Took too long. I was waiting for James Coe to get open, because he was going to be open in a couple of more seconds, but the blitz got there at the very last second. Jason Brown credited with the sack. James Coe off of a counter, and he's got open field. He gets 15 yards. 3rd and 1. So I'm just going to run this straight ahead with James Coe and hope I can get this conversion. Straight ahead of James Coe, and he gets it. More than a yard, he gets 5. Pretty good running by James Coe.
We're doing it, fam.
Getting down to my opponent's red zone has been tricky in the sense that I've done it, but I haven't converted as many times as I should have. That's a touchdown to Will Glover. They had a linebacker spying my quarterback there, trying to read where I was going to throw the ball. I saw that he was kind of just hovering in zone coverage there. I waited for Will Glover to get past him at the very last second, threw the ball, easy touchdown. 14-13 Washington State, 4 minutes to go in the second quarter.
See, fam, I told you they could blow a 3-0 lead.
So far, the story for USC has been the relative ease to move the ball offensively, but getting shut out of the end zone when they get down to the red zone. They've had to settle for 2 field goals after getting very good field position with the chance to score touchdowns. It could be 14-21 right now, but it's 14-13. They hand the ball off to Fenner for a gain of 3 yards. Again, a really odd day. Marcus Fenner, 9 carries, 5 yards, but does have that one touchdown run. So they throw the ball incomplete to the sideline. 3rd and 7.
So, USC, damn, this game turned around like really, really quick.
It did. You know, to be fair, Corey Green's been making good passes.
That's true.
So they complete it, but it's only a gain of 6.5, it looks like. It's 4th and inches. Are they going for it here? It doesn't look like it. They're going in punt formation. So for the first time today, we've actually prevented them from getting any sort of score on a drive. So they punt the ball away. Bishop on the return. He's got open field. Runs it for about 14 yards. Not bad. Really hoping he can break one of these punts for a punt return touchdown. But he's getting at least 8 to 10 on almost every single return. So we go back on offense with a chance to actually extend this lead to 8 if we can get a touchdown. Also going to try and bleed the clock a little bit so USC can get the ball back before halftime, since I do get the ball back to start the second half. I'm hoping I can maybe keep USC's offensive possessions down to as few as possible. Run the ball with James Coe, 9 yards, going to go no huddle, but I'm actually not snapping the ball immediately. I'm just going to let this bleed a little bit. Let's send Anthony Hampton in motion, get another blocker on the right side. Go with the sweep play, bumping inside, and it's wide open. James Coe, fighting off of defenders, gets a pretty good run. See what the official run for that was. It doesn't say, but it was about a 15 or 20 yard run. Something like that. We go power formation, first and 10, weaving a little bit, 3 yards up the middle. James Coe has had 9 carries for 58 yards and a touchdown.
I mean, and we're still in the first half, right?
Right. If this keeps up, he might have a 100-yard rushing day. And that's the focus. I told you I needed to commit more to running the ball with him, and so far, it has worked out. We swing it out to James Coe, and it's wide open, a gain of 11 yards. Well, 9 yards, but it's a first down. I forgot it wasn't quite first and 10, so when I saw him pass the first down marker, I said to myself, oh, that must be 11 yards. But no, it was 9 yards because it was second and 7 or something like that. But hey, it's a first down. I should shut up. We get the ball out to Hampton in the slot. He only gets 1 yard, though. The pursuit was there immediately. I am going no huddle, even though I said I wanted to bleed the clock a little bit. I still want to keep USC on their toes.
Yeah, fam, why are you being so hypocritical?
So I get the ball off to James Coe off of counter. Oh, wait, that's not James Coe. That's Dominique Riley. I guess we subbed in because Coe got tired. I didn't even notice that. I need to pay attention. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. That is not very professional of me. That was, in fact, Dominique Riley subbing in for James Coe because he got tired. But Coe is back in now for 3rd and inches. We're going to just jam this up the middle. We're going to get enough for a first down, 5 yards. Easy 3rd down conversion. We really need to punch this in for a touchdown. Going up by 8 points before halftime would be crucial to possibly winning this game. Because I'm not sure if my defense is going to be consistent enough to hold them out the end zone on every possession. And if this turns into a shootout, I just obviously need to score as many points as I can. And that's a completion to Wade Roberts for 12 yards. Oh no, Wade Roberts is injured.
Oh no.
He did take a hard hit when he was trying to turn that upfield for a touchdown. We're going to have to wait and see what the word on Wade Roberts is, but right now it's not looking good. He was motionless when the trainers came to him on the field.
I can't believe Wade Roberts is fucking dead.
Wade Roberts is not dead yet. We have to wait and see. We go read option with Corey Green. No gain. Still 2nd and goal at the 1. Just waiting. Intensely waiting to see what they say about him. I can't really afford to lose him. We do read option again. Corey Green gets in for the touchdown.
We've had so much success with the option today. That's great.
We have. Corey Green is one of those guys that plays a lot better in the read option than what you might think, just because you don't think he's going to be good at it because he's not that fast. But he's fast enough to get a couple of yards before the defender can get to him, basically. You know, get that 8 to 10 yard range on the option play, at the very least. So, with 30 seconds left before halftime, we kick it off. It goes into the end zone for a touchback. We have an 8-point lead, assuming we don't give up a huge play or a huge touchdown, God forbid, before halftime. Still no word on Wade Roberts, though, and that's got me worried. I'm not sure if that means it's good or bad.
Don't worry, be happy.
We get there for a sack. Loss of only 2, but still, at least that shows me that the pass rush has been getting there. It's Shannon Phillips, one of the defensive tackles who's been getting there. He's got 2 sacks today so far. And we just got word, Wade Roberts with a concussion. He is out for the rest of the game.
Got that Dale Jr. going on.
No, that really is some Matt Moore bullshit right there.
That's some 7-9 bullshit.
Wade Roberts played good, but unfortunately, he's going to have to miss the remainder of this game. Hopefully, that does not come back to haunt us. They throw it out to Marcus Fenner for a gain of 5 yards, 2nd and 5, and they're at the 45-yard line, so 16 seconds left, and they have both of their remaining timeouts. If they can get another huge play, they can attempt the field goal. Intercept interception by Steve Smith Sr. And he breaks the tackle. He's going down the sideline. Touchdown, Washington State.
Nice.
Steve Smith Sr. with the interception return for a touchdown with 5 seconds left before halftime.
That's some good shit right there, man.
Very good shit. I like that shit. We now have a 15-point lead, and we get the ball back to start the second half.
Can I just say, when we talk about Steve Smith Sr., I think about that scene from the Benchwarmers where the dude pulls out his birth certificate and it's just a piece of paper that says, I am 12. And his picture. I feel like that's what Smith is doing.
So for the last play before halftime, they give it to Fenner, and guess what? He loses yardage because he's been doing that a lot today. Desmond Hollis with the tackle for a loss. Marcus Fenner has 10 carries for 3 yards.
Nice.
Washington State on another incredible surge of defensive efficiency in the first half. I mean, that first drive really got me worried because they just went straight down the field with absolutely no problem. Our run defense has been absolute lockdown, though. Their quarterback does have about 180 passing yards. Bishop! Bishop's down the sideline! He almost took that all the way. Ricky Bishop, 56 yards on the return.
Ayo.
Washington State, they are balling out right now.
And you said you weren't going to beat USC.
I legitimately thought I wasn't going to, though. I mean, this game is supposed to be hard. It is at USC for crying out loud, you know? Corey Green on the option does get another good yard gain. It's 16 yards. A theme I'm noticing here is that USC is not blitzing on almost any play. So we go on a speed option to James Coe, pitch it for about 6 yards. They're only sending 3 to 4 defenders, you know, on the defensive line just about any given play. I think one time they blitzed like 6 guys, but other than that, it's been a fairly tame defensive day for USC so far. So, ooh, we tried to squeeze that in there on a deep post off of play action. Luckily, it was only knocked away and not intercepted. I can't believe that I even attempted that pass, honestly. It was not a good decision to throw that, but I still try to squeeze it in there. Oh, try to go on a comeback to my wide receiver on the right sideline there. They knock it away, but we are in field goal range. So this is a 41-yard attempt. See if we can't get this in there. It's up, and it's good. So it's 31-13.
So we're actually kind of having a blowout.
I wouldn't call it a full-scale blowout unless they were to like to turn the ball over here and we get another touchdown. Then I would say it's a blowout, but they have the offensive firepower. It's just more or less of the fact that when they try to run the ball, it doesn't work. And they run the ball at least 2 times per possession, and it's like first and second down, they're running the ball. And with these tackles for a loss my defense is getting, they're having to throw the ball in huge yardage situations. 3rd and 11, 3rd and 15, etc., etc. That was a bad pass by the USC quarterback. He threw it basically right to my guy, and he just swats it away.
I don't think they're having a good day, fam.
Well, not anymore. They had a good, you know, good game plan to start the game. It just hasn't worked out since then. Ooh. The defender almost got there for a sack, but the ball is just knocked away, so it's now 3rd and 10. The defense is getting a pass rush now. That's what I've noticed, is that he's not getting hardly any time to sit in the pocket. My defensive line is doing a really good job. He does get a completion there to Justin Davis for 10 yards, but they're rolling it a short 10 yards, 4th and inches. I I'm not sure if they're going to attempt this or not. It looks like they're just going to punt it away. They're being very conservative for a team that's losing by as much as they're losing by.
Yeah, I've noticed that's been a common thing in football games.
Like, if you're losing by, what, 21 or whatever, why would you be, like, very conservative in a situation like this? Ricky Bishop, 16-yard return. Can we just, like, stop and just applaud Ricky Bishop for his returning so far? He's been really good. Like, I mean, very good.
He has been an all-star.
Washington had it in his hands, but he dropped it. You want to know the story of this game? I have only 130-something passing yards, and we're in the third quarter for the team that's supposed to be so pass-heavy. That's an easy completion to Hampton, who's having to play outside receiver now. He's not playing slot because of the injury to Wade Roberts. I probably should have mentioned that. So maybe that's taking him out of his comfort zone. I hope not.
Don't kill anybody, fam.
We get a completion to Williams for a couple of good yards there. Maybe 13 or 14. 15. 15 yards to Williams. Pretty good. So the passing yardage hasn't been big today, but it's more or less a story of the fact that my quarterback Corey Green is 15 for 19, I think it said, or maybe it was 14 for 19.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's like it's a percentage day basically. I'm 15 for 20 now. That's what it is. I'm 15 for 20 for 173 yards now. Ooh, that was a risky pass though. I'll try to get that to Washington, who's playing the slot now, and he just had a defender all over him. Let's see if we can't get more read option success here. So we go read option to Corey Green, and he gets about 4 yards. Not bad. We're in field goal range, so I'm content with just adding 3 points if nothing else, you know. Don't do nothing too risky. I do want to get a touchdown, but at the same time, let's make a smart pass here and not force it. Yeah, just fucking Hail Mary that bitch. Aaron Rodgers, that bitch.
Didn't it work last time we did it, though?
Oh, I tried to throw that to Will Glover, try to just lob that up there and let him go up there and just pluck it out of the sky, but they had a defender swatted away at the last second. You know what? I'm feeling ballsy. Let's go for it. I know we're pretty much content with just taking 3 points here. Like, you know, it's the easy thing. Just take the points. I want to embarrass USC, though. And that's a touchdown to Washington. 17 yards.
Nice.
I want USC to remember this day and be embarrassed that they lost to Washington State by as much as they lost by.
But fam, we're winning the BCS championship, so they can't be embarrassed too much.
So you're saying we're going to go all the way?
No.
I would be happy if we get maximum 8 wins. If we can squeak out 8 wins on this very hard schedule, I would consider that a successful first year. I mean, technically speaking, I would consider just getting to a bowl game at 6 wins would be a good year, considering we've already beaten Auburn at Auburn. But we now have momentum, and that's something that I didn't think we were going to have this early in the season. So, you know, let's just ride this thing out, see how far we can go. They completed to Marcus Wheatley for 11 yards, first down. I would be amazed if they hand the ball off to Finner anymore, because on the flip side, you know, you don't want to completely...
They're really, really dumb.
Yes, like, I can understand not wanting to abandon the run game entirely and make yourself completely one-dimensional, but let's face it, he's had a horrible day. He's had a horrible day running the ball, and you're down by 25. 25 points. Who else had a 25-point lead?
I don't know, fam. Who had a 25-point lead?
Not USC.
That's true. It was the Falcons.
We get the sack there. He had to scramble out of the pocket, and as soon as he got out the pocket, the pursuit was there. Second and 16. Pass rush has been really good today. And one of the strong points for USC is supposed to be their offensive line, if their roster is as good as I think it is, like in terms of the offensive line ratings and all that. They have not played good today.
They haven't played well today.
They do get a completion there to make it a very short third down, third and seven. They throw it to the sideline, but I knock it away.
We're just like dominating at this point.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and say it. This is a blowout at this point, and it's weird because I've only scored 38 points, and blowouts usually aren't, you know, by the 30s. Like, a blowout is like 40, 50 something, right?
Right.
38 points is a very respectable score.
38 to nothing's a blowout.
No, the shocking thing is USC had 171 yards of offense in the first half, 40 yards of offense in the second half.
Yeah.
They have not moved the ball in the second half. Maybe that interception return for a touchdown at the end of the first half was just demoralizing, which I can understand if it was.
Probably.
We get a good completion there, only a short gain of 1 yard to Jason Washington, but hey, it's more or less about just moving the ball, Deacon and Diamond down the field. They have Glover wide open. I don't know what they're doing there. I throw the ball to James Coe for 6 yards. Third and three now. So Corey Green, 18 for 25. Two touchdown passes. Even though he did have that one interception early on, he had a much more efficient day today than he did in the last game. And the really weird part is that I haven't really even gone to James Coe a lot in the second half. It's been mostly in the passing game in the second half. We give the ball off to James Coe again, and that gets about 8 yards. I do want to give him at least a 100-yard rushing game here because I think he deserves it. So let's feed him the ball a little bit more. Ooh, I went for an inverted veer there, but I think I didn't hit A fast enough, so I ended up keeping it when I didn't want to keep it. You ever do that by accident?
Yeah.
I didn't mean to keep it there for Corey Green, but it just ended up being a kept run anyways. So we have to go for it on 3rd and 6 here.
8 o'clock.
We get into Washington for a gain of 16 yards. Jason Washington is playing pretty good in the absence of Wade Roberts. It seems like every game somebody else steps up. Last game it was Vincent. This game it's Jason Washington. I don't know why I said it so weird. Dominique Riley, 3 yard gain there.
Ma'am, are you about to go home, white girl on me?
No, I'm talking with a southern draw, but it's not, doesn't sound so southern when it's a bad imitation. We get the ball off to James Coe again, up the middle, 5, maybe 6 yards. The second half is going into the fourth quarter. Maybe one or two plays here before the third quarter is over. It's in the blitz, but I find it, I pick it up. Will Glover, 2 yards, first down though. Will Glover has 6 catches for 65 yards and a touchdown.
I just want to casually mention that there's still people I know that unironically play Second Life.
Unironically?
Unironically.
What is wrong with these people? Anthony Hampton makes a pretty good catch for about 15 yards down the sideline.
Also, I hate my life.
We throw the ball to the end zone, but it's intercepted by Henley. I think that says Henley. We did kind of force it there because I wanted Williams to get a touchdown catch there. He had position, but at the very last second, it seems like it was kind of overthrown. Maybe if I'd thrown that more directly at Williams, it would have been a completion or a touchdown. It was just a tad overthrown and ended up being an interception. I played with fire and I got burned, but that's fine. I got burned. USC completed to Marcus Wheely for about 20 yards, and that's the end of the third quarter. The first play of the fourth quarter, the Trojans have it at their own 40-yard line. They're going to scramble out of the pocket. He actually has open field. He gets 17 yards there, Anthony Sims, on the scramble. Probably the only thing he could have done there. So Anthony Sims has 5 carries, but he still has negative rushing yards from all the sacks, though. USC is not completely dead. If they get a touchdown here, I mean, it would be 38-20, and it wouldn't be impossible to come back from. Crazier things have happened in college football.
Run the clock.
Yeah, I need to burn
the
clock.
Don't pull your Kyle Shanahan card out.
Not trying to. So they complete it to Elton Greer for about 3 yards there. 3rd and 7 at my 40-yard line. I'm gonna send the blitz on this play. And it did not work out. They found the open receiver, Marcus Wheatley. He's been open on a lot of these plays today. 17 yards, first down. They are going down the field. They're now down to my 20-something yard line. They throw the ball to guess who? Marcus Wheatley, 14 yards down the sideline to my 9-yard line.
You gotta start covering them better, fam.
Marcus Wheatley, 7 catches, 121 yards.
Fam. Don't blow this.
He throws it out of the end zone and out of play, I guess I could say. Excuse me. I almost said interception for some reason when that clearly was not an interception. It was just an incompletion. See, they've been getting down to the red zone today, but they have not converted.
Well, fam, you gotta make sure they don't convert this time.
He was trying to scramble and turn that into a run, but Steve Smith, the corner, chases him down. It's a loss of 1 yard, but it technically goes down as a sack for Steve Smith. 3rd and goal at the 10-yard line. They go with a screen to the running back there, Finner, and he does get by my guy. It's a touchdown. He weaved out of the way, let the blockers get in front of him, and there was nobody there. It's a touchdown. So Finner, despite the very bad day running the ball, has a touchdown reception and a touchdown run. So Anthony Sims is 19 for 28, 298 interception, but now a touchdown pass. So, like I said, it's 38-20. Nothing's completely impossible here. I just need to.
And how much time's left?
5:17, and USC does have all 3 timeouts.
As long as you at least get a first down, I think you.
They're going for the onside kick here, and this is what I'm afraid of: is that they can do onside, but I recover it, thankfully. Just don't fumble it. So now the good thing is that they had to go for the onside there and they didn't get it. So now I get the ball at their own 39-yard line to start this drive. And I'm not going to chance it anymore. If I get down to scoring position, I'm just kicking that field goal. James Coe up the middle for a nice gain of 13. I'm just going to ride Coe to the finish line. So he officially now has 102 yards rushing today. We bounce it outside to James Cohen. He's there for another 11-yard run. He's averaging over 7 yards a carry today.
He's just having a monster game. Like, we need to be doing a run-first philosophy, I think.
Yeah, we might change that. I do hand it off to him again, but that time the pursuit was there. Penetration in the backfield. Lost the 2 yards. It's all good, though. I'm just content with just bleeding the clock. Getting in field goal range. Extending the lead.
Everything's dying around me. Hold on.
Okay. Hand the ball off to James Coe one more time. 1 yard gain. 3rd and 12, though. As much as I really want to throw this to convert, I'm more worried about just staying in field goal range, so I'm probably just going read option here.
Run the clock.
I go read option to James Coe, and he gets 2 yards. So we have to kick this field goal, but hey, I'm content with just getting this field goal. I'm learning from my mistake last time. Take the fucking field goal. It's up and it's good. 41-20. That is a 3-touchdown lead.
3-touchdown, 3-0.
Shh.
Fox blew up 3-0 lead.
I have yet to blow anything. I have not lost.
Except for me.
Okay,
let me ask you this.
What is the most you've lost by from blowing a lead? Like, what's the most blown lead you've ever had?
Blowing
in a game?
Lead? Like, the worst blowout I've had, I can remember.
They actually run the ball with Finner for 5 yards there.
Why?
Why are they running the ball with Finner? I don't know. Shooting themselves in the foot.
To run the ball.
No reason at all to run the ball right now. Oh, that should have been swatted. That's some bullshit. I dove for the swat, but he still completed it to Justin Davis for 23 yards.
Nice.
They complete it again to Davis, and he breaks a tackle. Gets down, 28-yard reception. Justin Davis, 5 receptions, 96 yards, and they're on the move again. This no huddle is starting to affect Washington State's defensive backs. It's a touchdown! Mark White, 19 yards!
Bam. You blow this lead.
Look, Washington State, they're not necessarily playing relaxed defense. It's just a matter of these wide receivers able to just get by them on some of these routes. It's been a consistent problem in the game. To be honest, the only reason why we had a stretch of dominance in the second quarter and third quarter was because my pass rush was playing really good. But now the pass rush is not there, and because of that, these receivers have the time. And when they have the time, they're getting consistent separation. So they're going for another onside kick here. I do recover it. So I have the ball at USC's 42-yard line.
With how much time?
3 minutes to go exactly, but it's only a 2-touchdown game.
Fam, you can run the ball.
I am running the ball.
But 3 minutes, you should not run. You should be able to run the clock out.
Yeah, I should be able to. This went from being a blowout to now a very interesting game. All along, USC has had the firepower on offense. It's just, I'm getting conservative here, and one could say, well, yeah, obviously run the clock, but being conservative, you know, runs the risk of having stuff like this happen. So we do hand it off to James Coe. He gets the first down there for a new set of chains, a new set of downs. So USC uses their first timeout because now they know that time is becoming a problem.
What's this joke with Al Davis and John Ross?
James Coe, 3-yard carry. I think the joke is that Al Davis is rolling over in his grave because John Ross ran so fast and he wanted to draft John Ross, but he's dead, so he can't do it.
Dead. Can't believe Al Davis.
Fucking dead.
Dead.
Dead as shit. Run the ball with James Coe, and it's a close to a first down. USC uses their last timeout, so really they have nothing else they can do here. If I pick up this, well, half a yard, it's basically game over because they can't stop the clock. And I do pick it up. It's a 3-yard carry by James Coe. And basically, that's it. I can just kneel on green at this point. It looks like we're going to get out of here with a comfortable, for the most part, very comfortable 2-touchdown win over USC that could have been more. Could have easily been a 25-point win. Ends up being a 14-point win. Still impressive, though. I just hope Wade Roberts is going to be okay for the next game because I really need him. That kind of mattered in the sense that his injury affected my offensive game plan passing the ball. I did rely on James Coe a lot more because of the injury to Wade Roberts, but also his injury really prevented me from making deep passes down the field. So when I did throw the ball, it was very short passes. And because of that, my passing yardage for this game was very median. It was like, what, 220, 230, something like that. It wasn't a huge day in the passing game because of it. Kneel on green one more time. I'll have to do it one last time after this. But this will be the last time I have to kneel on green because after this, the game clock will be under 40.
I want to die.
Yes, I want to die is in fact the name of this head coach. So we kneel on green one last time and that will be it. Washington State surprised Auburn at Auburn and now they shock USC at USC. The first Pac-12 game of the season, I honestly thought was going to be a loss, turns out to be a win.
See what
I'm
happens
amazed.
When you're optimistic, fam.
I'm amazed that I didn't just win this game, but for the most part, very comfortably won this game. Don't let the 14-point lead distract you from the fact that I was up by 25 at one point.
Don't let the fact that you were up 25 at one point let everyone... I'm just gonna quit. That was bad.
Yeah, just quit.
I'm gonna sink back into my little hole. I was actually gonna say something kind of relevant, but
I'm interested to see who ends up being the player of the game because I'm not sure if it's going to be James Coe. I feel it should be James Coe based off everything he did in this game. They might give it to Steve Smith Sr. for having that interception return for a touchdown. The first real highlight play of the season, which I'm awesome. I'm just amazed that he did it.
I mean, that's what they're gonna do, though.
Yeah, for the first highlight play of the year, for it to be by Steve Smith Sr. How perfect is that?
We gotta get that birth certificate checked.
Yeah, we do. They got a 37-year-old man playing on defense for a college football team. There it is. The interception breaks that tackle down the sideline. Nobody was there to stop him. They still haven't said anything about the player of the game. I'm just kind of waiting and seeing what they're going to say. Okay, they haven't said nothing, so it's like they forgot to put the graphic on for player of the game. Hello, who's the player of the game?
Your mom.
Hush, you're unoriginal. Okay, if they're not going to do it, I'm going to do it then. I'm going to player stats. I'm going to show you guys what James Coe did for me in this game. Because he played pretty good. 24 carries, 138, 5.7 yard average, and a touchdown. Only had a long of 15 yards. But really, it's just a matter of fact that he was getting so many of these runs 5-10 yards down the field before anybody even touched him. The best day receiving was Will Glover, 6 catches, 65 yards, and a touchdown for him. It was going to be a pretty good day for Wade Roberts, it looked like. He started the game 3 catches, 47 yards, and I was going to keep feeding him the ball, but he had the injury. Hopefully he's going to be okay for the next game, and I don't know who the next game is going to be against. Let's go ahead and find that out. But I'm confident now. We've played 2 of our road games to start the year. We haven't even played at home yet. And the road games are, you know, obviously harder. So getting these 2 really hard road games out of the way and coming out with a win in both of them bodes really well for us. I don't even fear anybody left on the schedule, and we have to go at Oregon. I'm not even fearing that now, because I know we have the talent and the team focus to actually get these wins. First home game is at... No, not at. I just said all that shit, and I still said at.
At.
I still said at. The fuck is my problem? It's at home against Old Dominion. Old Dominion at home.
You're going to lose against Old Dominion, and I'm going to laugh. It's
you're going to laugh, happen. And you're going to make fun of me.
I will make fun of you if you lose to Old Dominion.
That's it for the Washington State Dynasty, year one. This is Mock signing out, and Hannah signing out. See you guys later.
See you.